We are the future. We are the dream. We are the nation. We are part of this. Yes, we are so amazing. That's the least we shall be. At the heart of a nation changing history. How can they say that we are finished? We have just begun. Peace is an essential commodity in our world today. The present situation of tension and conflict globally, and Africa in particular, necessitates urgent efforts to promote sincere dialogue, mutual respect, justice, and peace. Thankfully, the Cardinal Onaikan Foundation for Peace, COFP, has remained relentless in the pursuit of peace and human development through her fellowship program. Through this initiative, COFP has continued to explore and expand her frontiers to lend a voice to the call for inclusiveness among diversities that has torn us apart if sustained development is to be achieved in the continent. The dinner night, which marked the opening of the fellowship program, was an evening to celebrate peace efforts and welcome the first set of the Cardinal Onaikan Foundation for Peace Fellows who were drawn from different parts of Nigeria. And significantly, this batch included fellows drawn from 10 African countries for its 2021-2022 fellowship program, which commenced on the 25th July 2021 in Abuja, Nigeria. Religious leaders, scholars, peace ambassadors, and other dignitaries in their different capacities graced the occasion to welcome the new set of fellows from across the 36 states of Nigeria and some African countries. Out of the over 652 applications that were sent in from all over Nigeria and Africa, these lucky 62 candidates were shortlisted for the 2021-2022 COFP Fellowship Program. They will be trained and equipped to be worthy peace ambassadors who will promote peace, dialogue, mediation and reconciliation on completion of their one-year fellowship program. Declaring the event open, the president and founder of COFP and Cardinal Archbishop Emeritus of Abuja Archdiocese, His Eminence John Cardinal Onaikan CON, in his remarks reminded religious leaders that though religion remains a significant component of social life on the African continent, its importance will continue for decades to come, which is why we all must learn to go beyond our religious differences and try to discover and celebrate our many common grounds of shared values and convictions.
Religion remains a significant component of social life on the African continent, and especially so in Nigeria. In fact, it has been projected that its importance will continue for decades to come. If this is so, then we must learn to go beyond our differences and try to discover and celebrate our many common grounds of shared values and convictions. We have been stressing and capitalizing on our differences of ethnicity, religion, culture, and political affiliation. Offer us the space to stress even more the many things that we have in common. This will make us discover the pleasant truth that what we have in common are far more important than our diversities.
In her welcome speech, the executive director of the COFP, Reverend Sister Agatha Chikelwe, DMMM, stated that COFP Fellowship Program is a trailblazer which has continued in one of the best traditions of the founder in the pursuit of faith, social justice, excellence, understanding, respect, and harmony.
COFP Fellowship Program is a trailblazer which has continued in the best tradition of our founder, who is here with us, John Cardinal Onaiko, in the pursuit of faith, social justice, excellence, understanding, respect, and harmony. It is our utmost mission to continuously use this platform in harnessing our rich diversities for peace through insightful interactions among the fellows and facilitators. We cannot deny that the future is full of uncertainties and, in fact, frightening to many. But the COFP Fellowship Program provides the platform for transforming conflicts, advancing good governance that promotes security and justice, and enhances building common ground for peace, which we believe are some of the ways that we can face the future together with confidence, and for which we earnestly look forward towards collaborating with your organization in sustaining this noble project.
The high point of the occasion was the official presentation of the 2021-2022 fellows to the audience. Maria Altaji belonged to the Congregation of Augustinian Sisters of Mercy. She is the sister in charge of the Augustinian Sisters of Mercy of Jesus Convent, Mubi, Adamawa State. She holds a BS in accounting from the Federal University, Maiduguri. Maria wants to learn new skills during the fellowship program. Bori Yilmaz is an Ethiopian and a Christian of the Orthodox Church. He is the program head, Ethiopia Interfaith Forum for Development, Dialogue and Action, AIFDA, Addis Ababa. He is convinced that the skills he would acquire will be instrumental to enhance his knowledge and skills on social inclusion, diversity, and also help him to become knowledgeable and professional peace-building advocate and advisor. Sue Batu is a Muslim from Ghana. She is a member of Ghana Conference for Religions for Peace and works with National Disaster Management, Elmina, Ghana. She studies secretariatship and management studies. Sue Batu wants to improve her knowledge in peace-building for enhanced peaceful coexistence in Ghana. Akintaye Akinyemi is a Cherubim and Seraphim Christian from Osun State. He is the chairman of the youth wing of KAN, Yowikan, Osun State. Akinyemi is of the opinion that he would use the knowledge gained from the fellowship program to organize terminal meetings among the youths in a society, since they are the future leaders. Saduya Suleiman is a Sunna Muslim from Zamfara State. She is the state Amira of the Federation of Muslim Women Association of Nigeria, Form 1 Zamfara. She holds MA in Arabic Studies. Binta wants to learn new skills in interreligious dialogue and mediation from the fellowship program.
More highlights of the event included a documentary on the 3 years journey of the CUFP fellowship program, with lots of achievements and positive impacts. With the inauguration of the 2021-2022 fellowship program, the 1-week-long Model 1 classes commenced.
The expectations that I have held prior to coming for the program has been wonderfully and awesomely met. Based on my interactions with my colleagues as well as the facilitators, it's been a very useful engagement. Being exposed to a lot of concepts, a lot of practices of Christian faith, I found some of the devotional act really endearing. And I've learned quite a lot in terms of accommodating, tolerating, understanding the viewpoint of other people without looking for supremacy of ideas or ideology or practices in my own religion as well as other people's religion.
What motivated me to attend this program is because I've attended several conferences and trainings on conflict mediation and transformation. But the interreligious aspect of this one was what attracted my attention. So I was coming with the expectation of learning more about how people from different faiths can meet and talk to bring solutions to conflict and mediation. And I have been very impressed by the sessions that we have had on interreligious dialogue, how to transform conflict, the experiences that we've shared from people from different faiths, Muslim, Christian, and others, also intercultural backgrounds. This has impacted my perception and perspective of people from these different backgrounds. And I believe that with the knowledge I have acquired during this training, it is going to help me, because I work in a multicultural environment, to better manage people with different religious backgrounds and to also broker peace in my community, which is plagued by a lot of conflicts related to cultural and religious problems.
When I first read about COFP program, I became convinced that this is the right capacity building event that will help me to enhance my knowledge about best tools to advocate peace and interreligious dialogue in my community. In the first model of this fellowship, we had chance to learn from the experts animating this model about some controversial issues, especially the jihad and crusades. And we agree in the end of this model that similarities between Christianity and Islam are more than differences. The good thing of participating in COFP is that you can learn from other fellows and from other brothers and sisters about Christianity. For me, as a Muslim raised in a Muslim community, I have never lived with Christians. I have the chance to learn from my brothers and sisters participating in this fellowship about Christianity and Christian faith. This cannot be learned from books or media, for instance, where are many fake information and misinformation. I can come now to my country equipped with the best tools about peace building and about catalyzing youth in my community to be peace builders and peace ambassadors.
If I say this is the best program I've ever attended, I'm not overemphasizing, because I think this is timely. Today, I can beat my chest and say, yes, I am reborn. I am a new person, because the notions I brought here were all discarded, were all deleted by the resourceful lecturers we had.
The COFP Foundation, as usual, remain grateful to the GHR Foundation, the Hilton Foundation, and the German Foreign Office for their kind support in sustaining this initiative that advances peace and human development in Africa. The future is